Hello friends, today we will discuss Faborsky rearrangement. So it's a Faborsky rearrangement. So Faborsky rearrangement. So first of all, before we start this two example, I will tell what Faborsky rearrangement is basically. So I will take a general example. So we need a alpha halo keto group. We need a alpha halo keto group like this, right? And here we use a base sodium ethoxide, right? So this base will abstract a proton from here. Okay, now what happens after the abstraction of proton? This will attack here and bromine group leaves. So this leads to formation of this intermediate, right? Now we have OAT group in the medium. That OAT group will attack and this will come here. So we are getting a 5-member ring with a CO2 ring. And this negative charge will, if we do the workup, and it will get protonated and we will get this proton. So this is the general mechanism of Faborsky reaction, right? So let's start with the first example. So in this example, we have a double bond. We have given a bromine. So bromine addition takes place over here. So if there is a bromine addition, so this will like this, right? First step is, now we have given a base, sodium ethoxide, right? So it will abstract the proton from here. It will abstract the proton from this. This is the acidic proton, right? So what happens? This attacks here and this carbon-bromine bond breaks. And that will give you, so that will keep like this intermediate, right? Fine. So we are getting this one. Now they have given a base, right? So they have given a base, that means OH minus. So this OH minus will attack here and this will go. So when it comes, there is a two possibility where it opens. Either this one can open or this one can open, right? So if this one will open, if there is a formation of a negative charge over here, this negative charge can help the bromine to leave. Since bromine is a good leaving group, if we can form a negative charge here, this can help the bromine to leave, right? So this negative charge will be formed in this position. So we have right now, we have this 5-member ring. We have here the acid group. Here we have the bromine and a negative charge over here. And this negative charge forms a double bond and this bromine leaves. So we are ended up with the 5-member ring. And here we have the this. So this is the product of this reaction, right? So this came in CSN net. I forgot in which year. I hope it's in 2015, right? So the next example, this is again a Faborsky reaction. So you have given a base. So this is, here we don't have any proton here, so we have a proton over here, so it will abstract the proton. Okay, so this will attack this carbon and bromine will leave. So there is a formation of 3-member ring, the bromine over here and this methyl substitution, right? Now what happens? Now we have OMe group, right? So OMe group, so it attacks here. Now there are two possibilities to open up the ring. So if it opens here, if there is a negative charge over here, then bromine will not get the option to leave the system. Okay, because bromine is a good leaving group. But if it leaves here, if there is a negative charge over here, this negative charge will can be able to form a double bond here, right? And this will help the bromine to leave, right? So what happens? So it attacks. The ring opening takes place like this. Okay, so this we have a bromine, we have a CO2Me, right? And we have a negative charge over here. Fine. Now what happens? This negative charge will form a CC double bond, and this bromine will leave. So we have ended up with this product. So this is the product for this reaction, right? So I hope you understood the Fibrovsky type reaction. And in the reactive intermediate part, this is the part 6 of reactive intermediates. And if there are more problems on reactive intermediate, I will upload it one by one. And so that's all for the video. Hope you like this video, and thank you for watching.